Ladies and gentlemen, this is Najat, and my partner Jonathan will be talking about cyberstalking today. What is cyberstalking? Cyberstalking is simply put online stalking. It has been defined as the use of technology, particularly the internet, to harass someone. Common characteristics include identity theft, false accusations, online threats, online monitoring, data destruction, or manipulation. Next, let's discuss some of the popular methods of cyberstalking. First, social media. Through the increased use of social media such as Facebook, Twitter, etc., an individual's profile, photos, and status updates may provide enough information for the cyberstalkers to become a potential victim of stalking without even being aware of the risk. Next, geotagging. Most of us upload images on social media. Geotagging is able to extract a plethora of information about you. GPS is another technology that is small enough to be dropped in car seats or cup holder. It allows harassers to know where you are at all times. Another type of method that allows for cyberstalking is malware. It is short form for malicious software. They are programs that install and run on your computer without your knowledge or consent. Some websites are designed to trick you into downloading and installing malware. Once installed, malware usually causes harm to the computer or user by deleting data or gaining access to personal information. Viruses, trojans, and spywares are few forms of malware that allow for remote access to a computer. Now, what are viruses? A virus is a computer program that replicates itself and spreads from computer to computer. Stalkers may try to damage the victim's computer by sending viruses. Next, a Trojan horse is often disguised as a legitimate software. Users are typically tricked by some form of social engineering into loading and executing Trojans on their system. Once activated, it can enable cybercriminals to spy on you, steal your sensitive data, and gain backdoor access to your system. The third type of malware that is used to spy on users' activities is spyware. It is usually used to steal financial details and passwords. Spyware can capture email addresses by enumerating email applications' address books, monitoring incoming and outgoing networking packets related to email, and scanning files on the system's disk for strings that match the format of an email address. It can also get keystrokes that captures and logs what a user on a computer types on a keyboard, typically without the user knowing. It can log emails sent, passwords entered, websites visited, private chat conversations, files, inputs, and more. Others include screenshots, authentication credentials, web form data, internet usage habits, and other personal information. Next, phishing is the attempt to acquire sensitive information. One may receive emails from someone pretending to be someone you already know. The emails are designed to trick you into giving away personal information such as usernames and passwords, credit card detail, and more. This is an example of phishing email. As you can see, the email address is usually incorrect. There is a tone of urgency. In this case, the subject line contains exclamation mark. It contains grammatical errors. It asks for username and password. There is usually a threat embedded in the message that says failure to update information may result in loss of something. Last method is wireless threats. If you fail to secure your wireless network, it could potentially open your internet connection to a surprising number of users. Doing so invites a number of problems. First, monitoring of your activity. Malicious users may be able to monitor your internet activity and steal passwords and other sensitive information. Next, direct attack on your computer. Malicious users may be able to access files on your computer, install spyware and other malicious programs, or take control of your computer.
I will now be talking about a cyber stalking case between Clayworth and Yan. Clayworth is a 35-year-old Canadian who has been unable to find a job for over 2 years because of his ex-girlfriend. She broke into his apartment and stole his laptop and hard drive. Those were the only two things she needed to destroy his physical and digital life. She continues to cyberstalk him, and there is little that can be done. Here is a still image of her in his hallway, packing up his two properties. Since then, negative Facebook posts have become the new norm for him. Embarrassing memes are posted online about him. Because of his ex-girlfriend, blogs have been posting lies about him having STDs, cheating, being a child molester, and being physically involved with the students. Here is a quote of him describing his life lately. Methods of prevention. Be mindful of what you share online. Don't post your schedule online. It makes you easily trackable and predictable. A lot of cyber stalkers do not know that they are stalking you. They may be delusional or obsessed with you. Regularly search yourself online. Doing a Google search of your name and number will show you if fake stories or profiles of you are online. Never give away too much personal information. It could be used against you to create very accurate fake profiles of you. Utilize online programs to track cookies. This could show you if you are being tracked by third parties who could steal your information. Reset your passwords frequently. This reduces the chances of keyloggers having your password and using it against you. Remember to keep your firewall and virus scanners up to date to keep malicious things away from your computer. Thank you for taking the time to listen, and please stay safe online.